What is something free from the internet which everyone should take advantage of? I save these threads every time they come up and never reference them again. Saves post. 3 years later, oh yeah, I saved that. Wolfram Alpha. IDK if it's already been said, but Wolfram Alpha was a lifesaver for checking answers when taking Calc 1, 2, 3 in college. Definitely useful for all sorts of answers, but answers for science and math questions. It's great. Wolfram Alpha is legit the best online calculator. It's super powerful and explains it. I would also add that Desmos is a great online graphing software. Even if you don't need to graph anything, Desmos is great if you just want to work with some equations without having to write anything down. Google Scholar. If you type that in and then look up anything you want, the results are all scholarly work. If you type in volcanoes, you will get an absolute ton of scientific documents about volcanoes. Any research that is being done on them. Any papers that have been written about them. And any data you might want is there. Next time you write a paper for a science class, check out Google Scholar. Edit 1. Thanks everyone for the awards. While it is true that a lot of things require payment, but if you're a college student and you have a student ML, you should be able to access a lot of the information. And then C-Hub. All you do is type the DOI of your chosen research paper and you get a free, although not quite legal, PDF. Perfect if you don't have access to a particular library. Just to tie in an LPT I've seen kicking around. If you email some of the paper's authors, they'll probably send you a PDF for free. They're allowed to distribute their own work directly. Just not in mass. Creddle.io, a free resume builder site. You fill it out like an online application, and it generates your resume in different styles for you. Landed me a couple of jobs after I started using it. Edit. Thank you for the awards everyone. But I'd like to give credit where it's due. Big thanks to you /Pcarry, creator of the site. Awesome. Thank you. Noticed it's completely free. Why? They will have all of my personal information. Do you think it's safe? It remains free, since I built it originally for students and new grads. But there's a $5 premium add-on that helps fund the site. There are only two ways personal information is given to others, both of which are explicit user actions. 1. When you publish your resume to an unlisted URL, this makes your resume viewable to people who have the link you give them. And 2. Using your resume to autofill your name, email, and location in the SignUp form, if you choose to sign up for ZipRecruiter job listing emails, and only those things. These details are in the FAQ and privacy policy. But just know that the information that you put in Creddle isn't then sent away to a third party individually or in aggregate. There's no need for it, and I wouldn't want that to happen to my information either. https://10minutemail.com/ If a website is asking for your email, and you don't want your original email to be spammed, you can use the email found on this website that self-destructs after 10 minutes. Edit. I only expected this to receive a couple of upvotes, and I'm surprised this became so popular. So I would like to add that some people in the replies suggest using https://tempmail.org/n/, and it's definitely much better than 10 minute mail because the email does not self-destruct after 10 minutes and 10 minute mail is blocked on more domains than tempmail. https://www.reddit.com/r/fullmovisaniout/. You could use Streamio instead. Higher quality and subtitles come with it. I like Streamio too. But, have you ever used Kodi before? Cinema APK is the best for Android-based TVs, like the Fire Stick. I got a lot more use out of that than I ever did with Kodi and its plugins. Slightly controversial, but library genesis. Almost every science textbook you could ever want for free. However, you're not compensating authors/publishers for their work. So the morality is debated. But if you want access to knowledge for free, there it is. I haven't ever encountered any issues like viruses either. Hi. Publish scientist here, even through textbooks. We don't make any money off of that. We get our money directly from research grants. Oftentimes, through universities we are working at. Uni pays us X dollars under the understanding we will be filling out and filing for tons of grants. Grants pay us to do specific research we are skilled in. They reap the rewards, fame, usefulness, etc. And we get credit for the discovery and an attaboy. I have a published article through my research with plants and medicine. It's published in the Omega Scientific Journal. But I'm not doxxing myself, so that's as far as I'll admit to it. Anyhow, you the viewer would have to pay to see the full article in some instances. However, neither me or my colleagues see even one penny of it. That's all on the publishers. We are not bothered one bit by you having gotten the article somehow for free. Most of us want to share our work as much as possible. We are huge nerds. https://archive.org. Tons of free music, audiobooks, news reports, newspaper scans, video games, software and movies. If you haven't already, please look for anything important you have saved on a USB stick or on your hard drive and archive it here. If you find it important or interesting enough, this site is awesome. The best feature about archive.org is the Wayback Machine. It saved me so many times when I need to look at a page on a website, but it was taken down. The Wayback Machine is incredible. Some websites I made when I was a cringy 14-year-old are still on that bad boy from the early mid-2000s. Alternative 2, http://alternativeito.net. It is a site that shows you alternatives to any software you are looking for. If there is a paid application you would like to use, you can find a free or open source version. Do you like a program but it slows down your computer? You can find a lightweight alternative. I'm a little late, but if you're ever feeling stressed or feeling the itch to travel when you can't, you should try Windowswap. https://www.windowswap.com/. Just click the button, and it will randomly take you to a recorded video of the view out random folks' windows all over the world. You can even upload your own window footage for others to enjoy. It's so calming. Eater, recorded. These aren't live. It'd be neat if they were. But part of why I love it isn't the real-time aspect, but rather just getting to see a random snapshot of what some other human looks at in their day-to-day life. Bro, I was watching this Russian cam, and then the whole thing shook up like crazy, and I was like earthquake. Then an ominous black figure covered the whole screen. Meow. So calming. Film Rise channels on YouTube. Untold hours of free documentary TV series, including old school unsolved mysteries. This is always how I've watched Hell's Kitchen fully uncensored. eSound, it's basically a ripoff of Spotify, except you don't have to pay for nothing, and listen to any song available on YouTube. AHH, the modern day Groover Shark. Rest in peace to all my Groover Shark playlists. Rest in peace the founder of Groover Shark. Online courses and guides. The fact that you can learn anything for free at home is amazing. Like 40 years ago, you had to actually pay for lessons and go away from your home. Nowadays you can do everything online. Want to learn knitting? You got it. Want to learn to speak a foreign language? You got that too. Want to study for an upcoming test? You can. But you probably won't. Isn't the internet just amazing? Want to study for an upcoming test? You can. But you probably won't. Why did you have to make it so personal? It's always personal. Now get off your couch. Stop eating popcorn. Put on a shirt and study for your test. Joke's on you, I'm already wearing a shirt. Good thing he didn't say anything about pants. You basically did already enough for your test. You can go easy on yourself, mate. People like you is why I fail the test. Wikipedia. We take that site for granted. Big time. There are few things in this world that do not have a Wikipedia page. People have dedicated hours, days, even their entire lives to filling the site up with all the knowledge one could ever need. All that information is free. Want to learn about the history of the escalator? Wikipedia has it. Interested in the Civil War? You bet you can find it on Wikipedia. Wikipedia will not be around forever. Folks, use it while you have it. Read random articles. It's fun. I'm one of those dorks that donates the $3 they awkwardly ask for each year. Worth it. I donated occasionally, though recently unsubscribed from their mailing list after they sent a suggestion that I could include Wikipedia in my will. Trying too hard there, I think. This made me laugh so hard, hahaha. And please, upon your death, think of Wikipedia. Apostrophe. I know three websites to make scaliciasymbolab.com. Type in any math problem, and it will provide you with steps to solve any answer. Table.com. Website for chemistry. Periodical table. User-friendly website to analyze any element from the table in detail. Propostia.com. Rewrite any article with ease. Symbolab lock their steps now. / Just put the locked step back into it. Works about half the time. Alternative 2. https://www.alternativeito.net. For when you want to find an alternative to an any app. The database is massive. And you can filter by platform and license. Product Hunt. https://www.producthunt.com. Makers, mostly startups. But bigger names too, post their brand new products, mostly websites and apps. Here, the community is mostly professional devs and designers. So everything is super polished. Great place to find incredibly useful apps. Product Hunt got too crowded, and now any crappy software is there. Was really good when they first started. Yout.com. https://yout.com/. It lets you convert any YouTube video into an audio or video file. YouTube DLG. https://mrs0m30n3. github.io/yout.dlgui/. Is my preference, since it is an application, not a website. You can also choose what file format you want to download in, and choose what folder it goes into. In the US, weather. Gov.no ads and a great resource for all things weather. You can also use the following affiliated sites: NHC, NOAA, Gov, National Hurricane Center. For tracking tropical threats, pick NOAA, Gov, Storm Prediction Center. For forecasting severe thunderstorms and tornadoes, technically paid for by your tax dollars, but free other than that. Decimus Scientific and graphing calculators are free and quite useful. Also, the website WolframAlpha can solve a ton of math problems for you. That one government website, where you can find old assets in your name and claim them for money. I think I heard about it on Reddit actually. I haven't been able to claim anything personally, but I've helped my parents claim about $200 worth. Wish I could remember the name of it. Edit. In the US, the website is unclaimed. Org. Basically a directory. Each state has its own separate page. Also, thanks for my first award, and for my most upvoted comment ever. Each state also has their own website. I found $248 from a checking account, opened for me, when I was a baby. They probably deposited $245, and you got you some interest there. Language learning books for free at archive.org. Languages don't really change much over decades. And most of those books are from 1850 to 1930. They slowly explain grammar, which is the skeleton of the language. I've been trying to learn Japanese for a while now. Never could find a source that I would trust, or just trust myself with. Lol. I'm not paying X amount of dollars or whenever, if I'm just not going to learn the language right. Recommend me language learning sites / programs. If I had a uTorrent for so much language learning stuff, but I forget it. Find out where people, both famous and non-famous, are buried. Read what's inscribed on their monuments. Read obits. And see comments posted by viewers. Find a Grave can also be a helpful site for doing free family genealogy, and locating where people have been interred, that you lost touch with over time. https://www.findagrave.com/. I never found out where a loved one was buried after his funeral. Thank you for posting this, as I was finally able to find it. Thank you so much for sharing this. Chacha_Mary. Your comment is heartwarming and much appreciated. Chacha real smooth. This site is probably illegal, but lets you watch anything free, and in a time where movies are straight to their respective streaming platforms, this is prime time. https://flixc.net. https://flixc.net. The Wayback Machine. I had a 500 page online thing I wanted to save, but not copy paste into a Google document. Just pop the URL of each page into the Wayback Machine and now it's saved there forever. It's awesome. DuckDuckGo. Removes political filters and echo chambers from your searches. How does it work exactly? It doesn't tailor current searches based on past searches. It also doesn't sell your data to advertisers. And you can delete all browsing data at the push of one button. I believe it's ads on searches. The ones that pop to the top before the thing you're actually searching for. Alright, cool. That makes sense. Thanks. I should add that those ads are totally random and not based on anything except your country of search. So I can get an ad for a condo in Mumbai while staying in New Delhi. Open Office. I refuse to pay for Microsoft Office. It's virtually identical and easy to use. LibreOffice is FOSS as well. I've had great luck with it over the years and prefer it to Apache O. https://documenterahaven.com/literally-hundreds-of-streaming-documentaries. All arranged by topic. All free. Free open source software. There are great free alternatives out there for lots of paid software. I tried to explain this to a supervisor once in a very sales driven field. And she just absolutely couldn't comprehend the whole concept that useful stuff could be available for free. Wait till she hears about the library. It was more like extreme skepticism that anybody would spend so much time working on stuff and not making any money from it, as well as doubts about quality control. But when somebody has already made their mind up about something, it's hard to get them to understand it. I mean, those are valid concerns. Most people don't work for free, and there isn't much accountability for hobby projects. Of course, I know good free software exists. I use plenty of it, but I 100% understand the skepticism. https://www.fuachcartoononline.tv/for-your-cartoon-and-anime-needs. I have been using this website for years, and I'm watching Star Wars The Clone Wars on it right now. No Netflix. No Hulu. No cable. No Disney Plus or Apple TV. For me, there is only fuachcartoononline.tv. You can learn to cook just about anything from YouTube. Some guy keeps telling me I totally suck at cooking. Also something about Wang Jangles. Internet Archives Open Library, https://openlibrary.org/. You can check out books from a shit ton of different public libraries. For free. It's insane. 7-Zip. I never got the WinRAR jokes, because I never used it. I'm surprised you didn't get the jokes, they're fairly self-evident. The joke is that people use the trial instead of buying it, so it shows nag screens. A list of lists of free stuffs, /jithub.com/syndrasaurus/awesome. Wouldn't that list have to contain itself? Screen2GIF, https://www.screen2gif.com/. This program was introduced to me at my last company by a cat guy, and he swore by it. Since then, so do I. Take GIF clips at any time, and it's free. I use it to show how my code works in the application for the PRs. r/AskReddit After Dark for all of your horny questions, so they stop getting reposted here. Nice. Some nice extensions. All of these are free and open source software. uBlock Origin makes the internet effectively ad-free. Blocks analytics and tracking services like Matomo and Google Analytics. Has a useful assortment of utilities for blocking and controlling annoyances on web pages. This is a must-have for pretty much anyone. Universal Bypass instantly bypasses at links and URL shorteners like ad, fly, https://ad/fly, and such. Sponsor block. Crowdsourced skipping of YouTube sponsor sections. Great user experience and saves a bunch of time if you use YouTube a ton. You can also contribute your own segments very, very easily. Stylus allows injecting custom styler sheets into web pages you visit, effectively making any page you visit themeable. If you know CSS, this is a great tool. If you don't know CSS, there are plenty of community managed user styles out there which allow you to customize and theme web pages in one click. Shields up at grc.comps/www.grc.com/x/northeast.dll.bh0bkid2. It will help you check your router for any exposure or risk with open holes in your firewall. Misunderstood this, so I was going to say going for a walk. Since everyone's posting online stuff, I'll contribute. Artbreeder, https://www.artbreeder. reddit.com/. You're able to mix images together to create something new, and keep tweaking it until you get something you like. Personally, I like using it to create characters that look similar to the ones in my head, useful for story writing. I thought the same thing. Was going to say hiking. OpenStax has free digital textbooks for various courses and universities courtesy of Bill and Melinda Gates. https://openstax.org/. Amazon Smile, same as Amazon, but buying through Amazon Smile donates money to a charity of your choice. No charge to you at Bloker and Cookie Blocker. Damn it, I thought Amazon had invested in the toothbrush games market.